Hey folks, Engineer 775. I never did get to show you the finished install of this HotSpot Energy 48 volt. This is a DC mini split, and it is a 1 ton or 12,000 BTU unit. It has, of course, like many of these, have their remote, so you can put it in cool, dry, auto. You can just dehumidify if you want. Multiple fan speeds, there's timers, typical remote setup. And it's in a very nice basement, and it is dehumidifying, controlling the temperature. It's where this is located. It gets cold, gets down to 10 degrees, gets in the teens, and it was keeping the basement toasty. Customer's not here too often, and so I'm just resetting it. Had an issue. We had a big storm, lightning strike, and we had to do some ground fault troubleshooting, and thankfully Mr. Johnny Valentine was on the other end of the line, so I came up here, did some troubleshooting, got her back up and running. So good working with Gain Solar as always. And these are some of the goodies that I have and offer when we talk about infrastructure that works. This is a year and a half of running this thing really hard. I've come here and it's been set on like 76 in heat mode and running all winter long. Let me show you the outdoor unit. This is a pretty cool spot, quiet, really nice. And they have some Mitsubishis, and one of them is also running off of the inverter. But in order to save capacity, I'm gonna try not to get the heating and air guy's phone number in here. This is the outdoor unit, nothing fancy on it, but it is DC. It's a HotSpot Energy inverter. I'm trying not to get the contractor's name and number in here that actually installed and did the line set. This was about 40 feet from the with wire lengthwise in terms of getting the indoor unit tied in. Here we go, the fan's just coming on now, so compressor's running, it's super quiet. Say that's loud, but these phones always pick up a lot of noise. It's very quiet, extremely quiet. So we're running this off of the battery alone. We're not inverting, and that frees up inverter capacity to do other things like run your well pump or do whatever. So I'm just up here double checking a system that we did quite a while ago. This is the Star Wars. I'll put a link to it. This is the Star Wars system we did about a year and a half ago. Everything's good. We just had a tremendous storm. Power was out, and we popped a fuse on our ground fault. I haven't been able to, we've been troubleshooting it. So I just put a new fuse in and everything's fine. So I think it was just hopefully some static electricity on the line. Johnny got Magnum on the line and we came up with a procedure to troubleshoot it. But yeah, I will close the boxes, I promise. I was just making sure everything was kosher, and so we're good. So it's a really, you know, the regular Mitsubishi mini splits are awesome, and so they're good too. But I'm really liking this DC. It's a very unique air conditioner, but it cannot run solar direct. So you have to have a battery to basically provide that stable voltage for it to run. She is just a coolin'. Can you feel it? It is so nice. So it keeps this basement apartment really, really nice. And that's all done off the battery. And I'm just, I got a mess in here now because I was just troubleshooting. Let me just show you. Okay, oh, it's a mess. Kind of embarrassed. But I was just troubleshooting these trackers. And this is the DC disconnect we put in for the mini split. So there's two appliances that we're running strictly off of battery. So we've got solar coming through and from the charge controllers to the battery, which is over here. Our classics, same old. Sorry, I didn't set up my stage here first. You see, yeah, classic lead acid, the 24 2 volt cells. And so just hanging out here, making sure everything's working. But this Sundancer 48 volt freezer that I'm using as a workbench right now is also running off of the battery. So those two appliances actually were coming off of these DC appliances off of this breaker. They don't use hardly any, they're not using hardly any power. That 110 unit uses 800 watts max. And we just have a disconnect. The reason I have a disconnect here and we have it labeled turn off before equalize, because in order to equalize this battery, we've got to, it cranks it up to like 63 volts. And that's too high for the air conditioner. So if we go into equalizing the battery, we shut this off, equalize, and we need to do that soon. So everything's pretty good. I just got to button these things up and put these PTs. These are stackable charge controllers. I think they can take at least 5,000 watts. I think they have it set up. I think Johnny was the first one to stack three of these Magnums, and gotta have your dip switches set correctly. This is the master, two slaves. I think they can stack up to 17 of these. Maybe it was seven. Seven or 17. I'll have to look at the manual again. And just keep daisy chaining them together. And so we had a fault, and I'm chalking it up to lightning. I put a new fuse in here, a GFDI fuse. And you don't put a fuse in the other ones. And so that's that. Okay. We have one more. This is our critical loads panel, and we do have, we thought we had moved all the circuits, but we found we did not. So it's another thing I got to do is move the circuit over here that we thought was on the system. And so it's always something after a system is in and tested and actually go through and live through a grid down test or actual grid down scenario, you find out if your system is exactly what we told you it was. So sometimes we have to make some changes, and we just have to move one circuit. It's not gonna be a big deal, and we'll do that. Sometimes people might want a different appliance, or well, we just forgot something, and we'll fix it. So this is the dual magnet. Anyway, I'm telling you more about the solar system. I really wanted to tell you about the hot spot. So we're in this basement, and I don't know how many square feet it is, but it's able to really make it nice. There's a bedroom, bathroom. It's like a whole apartment. And this one little mini split just keeps it dehumidified, very comfortable. And if you have any questions about it, let me know. I'd be happy to get you one of these or help you design a system. Sometimes these are nice add-ons to an existing solar system if you have 48 volts, or you can do a standalone. And what you got to figure out where you live is how many hours of operation do you want it to run. If it's a 24/7 operation and heat and cooling, then you're going to have a pretty good sized battery bank and the solar to accompany it. The unit itself is, oh, don't hold me, it's about $1,600. But then when you add batteries and solar charge controllers in the works, you get up there $3,000 to $4,000. But it's completely DC, so there's a benefit there. And oh, that feels good. I'm just staying here on this video because this feels good. Anyway, hope that answered some of your questions. Just showing you some of the features. About energy, and we have these at go to practicalpreppers.com under air conditioning, and we have AC/DC mini splits, and we have the DC mini splits. Be glad to get you one coming your way. We're gonna install one next week out in Georgia somewhere at an undisclosed location. All right, engineer 775 signing off.